Good morning and God bless you. We're delighted to have you with us here this morning. Maybe this is your first time tuning in and joining us. We extend a warm welcome to you and trust you're blessed with what you hear today. 1 Samuel 30, and we are going to begin reading. We're going to just jump through this passage and read a few scriptures. First of all, in verse number 6, David was greatly distressed, for the people spake of stoning him, because of the soul of all the people was grieved, every man for his sons and for his daughters. But David encouraged himself in the Lord his God. Verse number 8, and David inquired at the Lord, saying, shall I pursue after this troop? Shall I overtake them? And God answered him, pursue, for thou shalt surely overtake them and without fail recover all. And then verse number 18, and David recovered all that the Amalekites had carried away, and David rescued his two wives. Interesting title for you this morning. Dry your eyes, blow your nose, and grab your sword. Dry your eyes, blow your nose, and grab your sword. Incredibly famous passage of scripture. Of course, David is in a place. He's actually on the run from a king that wanted him dead. And he finds himself in some unusual alliances here. And here at Ziklag is mentioned several times in scripture, but this is by far the most notable occurrence and occasion associated with Ziklag. But he comes back, he finds the entire encampment of David and his mighty men, 600 mighty men. And it is burned with fire, it is rubble, and it is absolutely vacant. The Amalekites have come in and taken his wives, the wives of all of these 600 men, their family, their children, their possessions. It is rubble, and the only thing that's left is a plume of smoke and fire. The men, in their absolute, utter grief, the expression of grief was so severe. And honestly, I cannot think of another place in the entirety of the Word of God that records such an emotionally severe moment where David's mighty men spake of stoning him, because of this incredible emotional loss and deprivation. David is absolutely the picture of the perfect leader under extreme pressure. Extreme pressure. He already has a king that hates his guts, that wants to see him dead, wants to see him absolutely eliminated. And now the mighty men that followed David are speaking of stoning him. An incredibly extreme response. But David does the right thing. He keeps a cool head. He absolutely recognizes the emotional absolute extreme emotionalism that's here. Men that have followed him that have lost everything. It's absolute tragedy. But David keeps a cool head, and he recognizes, he keeps the right things in focus. And that is, God is with me. God is with me. He remembered some things. And David goes to prayer, begins to pray. He has the ephod with him. It's an extreme environment. The entire environment surrounding him is one of emotional chaos. But yet David finds a place to pray and talk to his God. Shall I pursue? Shall I recover? Shall I pursue after this? Shall I go after this? What shall I do? And God's response is recorded here for all of us for the ages. Go and thou shalt pursue and thou shalt recover all. David comes out of this prayer room, staring into the swollen eyes, red faces, puffy eyes, still the absolute grief, the noise of this grief is filling the air, and probably no doubt some of the mighty men have even picked up rocks, maybe even selected which rock they're about to throw. Dry your eyes, blow your nose, and grab your sword. It's time to follow leadership. It's time to go and recover all. It's time to eliminate the enemy. You know, people can go through their deals, and oftentimes, of course, this is what happens through the entirety of Moses leading the nation of Israel. Whenever there's an issue, Moses is the first one to be blamed for this. This is still true today. There are people that one little ripple, one little deal, one little thing they have to work through, they have an issue with leadership. And I don't think there's any better example to talk about this than the example here with David's mighty men. They've already followed him. They've already express their loyalty. They've already made him their leader, their divinely appointed and anointed leader. But tragedy goes so far and cuts so deep and the loss so great that they turn on leadership. There's much to be gleaned in this part of scripture. You didn't get your way. Something didn't work out. Your dreams didn't materialize. Your unrealistic expectations, or maybe in the course of obeying and following, there's tragedy that strikes. You have to keep yourself in check. Dry your eyes, blow your nose, and grab your sword. Let's go get back what you lost. I'm reminded of a scripture in 2 Timothy chapter number 2. I've been fascinated with this particular passage of scripture ever since I've been saved, almost 40 years, where it talks about in 2 Timothy chapter 2, verses 23 forward, where he says, the servant of the Lord must strive. Here again, the servant of the Lord has to keep his head. He has to keep his heart. He cannot emote. He cannot be affected. He cannot be impacted. He cannot be moved from his posture of sobriety and gravity because of the greater issues at hand. The servant of the Lord must not strive, apt to teach, gentle, instructing those that oppose themselves, if God peradventure will give them repentance to the acknowledging of the truth, that they may recover. Everybody said recover. The leader, those that are leading, have got to comprehend that my role is to help bring about recovery, and that they may recover themselves from the snare of the devil that are being taken captive by him at his will. So leadership, it is a huge mistake to turn on leadership. And both of these examples that I gave you here in 1 Samuel and then the other one in 2 Timothy. Leadership is going to be the divine instrumentation that is going to help you recover and regain what you have lost. I love this here in 1 Samuel chapter number 3 because 400 of the men grab their swords and they're ready to follow David again. Leadership has direction. Leadership is heard from God. I don't care how dark it may be. I don't care how stormy the night. I don't care how grief-stricken you might be. I don't care what the loss is. Stay attached to your God-called leader, not just some guy that leaves and does his own thing, some wandering star, somebody that just says, you know what, I'm not getting my way around here, so I'm just going to go do my own thing. That's an indicator of trouble. That's not an indicator of being spiritually led or God-called. A God-called, God-placed leader has made full proof of their ministry, not just somebody that, I want a pulpit, I want to go do this, I want this, I've got to satisfy some deeper inner thing that I've had. If you don't go about it the right way, that is not an approved leader. David was an anointed, appointed leader. Goliath, ladies and gentlemen, Goliath bit the dust and he took off his head. He had some corn in the crib. 400 of those mighty men dried their eyes, they blew their nose, and they grabbed their sword. 200 were so faint, they were so overcome with grief that David said, all right, he was a good leader. He recognizes you can't make the journey right now. You stay here and guard what we got left here. We'll come back. They go, they eliminate the enemy, they recover what was stolen from them, and they bring everything back. Two things. Not only did they get back what they had lost, because they followed the leader, they brought back the spoil. They brought back even that, they brought back even that which belonged to the devil. And so they not only recovered all, but they brought back spoil. Some of the men that noted these types of things that didn't have, they weren't in the same place where David, the anointed, appointed leader was, they said, the 200 that were watching the stuff, they're not going to get their stuff back. And they're not going to get any of the spoil back. Pardon me. They are not going to receive of the spoil because they did not go with us. David said, hold it. They had a very important role here. Even though they didn't go with us, they guarded this stuff. We're not going to play that game. Every man is going to be restored. Everybody is going to partake of the spoil. In fact, we have so much spoil, we're going to send it to others that weren't even a part of this. And this is David's spoil. In a world that is attacking authority, in a world where there's lawlessness, in a world that is all about attacking those that are in authority, questioning authority, throwing rocks, throwing spears, firing arrows, shooting fiery darts. Dry your eyes, blow your nose, and grab your sword. Let's go get back what was taken from you. God bless. Thank you for joining us here today. We'll look forward to seeing you tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.